Hey guys, Konstantin here, and this is my character Aerium. In this tutorial, we are going to cover hair concept sculpt inside ZBrush. The sculpt will be used as a guide for placing real-time hair cards in the second part of this series. I'm starting from a sphere, but you can just duplicate a head and use it as a base. In this chapter, I want to establish the main form and shape of hair, plus direction of this particular hair card. Let's stop for a second and talk about feminine hairline. This facial landmark is called glabella, and we can use it as a measure point to find the start of the hairline. Now I must say that each face is different and the measure I will explain you now is a gold middle. Most of the people will fail inside this. But if you're going to create a likeness, please measure this on the particular face you're after. Now, the average female hairline is 5.5 cm above the glabella. The cool part is that average nose is also 5.5 cm. That means that if you will take the nose from the tip to glabella, this will be the same length as glabella to the hairline. I'm using DynaMesh on this stage to establish the bigger forms, and in the near future we are going to ZRemesh it. Here I started to break the form into clumps using the standard brush, pressing Alt to add the sharp lines and not just carve them inside. The reason I'm doing it on the base is that it will not just guide me when I will start to add clumps in second chapter, but will also be a nice blocker if you'll have gaps between the geometry that will be on top. It will still work fine. The main blocks are established and the time to ZRemesh everything has come. This will give me lower subdiffs for manipulation if needed without ruining the high poly sculpted lines. Adding hairband placeholder for now using a simple cylinder, I'll take care of it after the hair will be done, as I'll be manipulating the shape and placement of it as we go. Cleaning the shape increases with the same damn standard using a higher subdiff. We are almost done with this stage and I'm happy with the overall shape of it. In this stage you will add clumps using IMM brush. There are plenty of good ones and you can always create yours. The one I'm using this tutorial is called Hair Saloon, a really cool name, and it was created by Sergio Camprubi. God, I hope I read it right. He is a character artist from Barcelona, Spain. I'll put a link to it on the credits. Each clump consists of 3 to 4 sump clumps that we will separate in the third chapter. Right now I'm focusing on the thickness of each clump and quantity of them. This is strictly dependent on the haircut you after. This particular Black Widow hair are really messy after a battle, so I need more clumps to create more depth and disorder to communicate the hairstyle better. If I were creating, for example, night out hair that we really that are really nicely organized by the hairdresser, I'll probably sculpt them as one bunch and add some flyaways to give them life. So yeah, each hairstyle is different, there's no one solution for them all. Here you can see me adding a base for side hairs. I will draw the clumps on top of it and then delete the base to create negative space between the clumps. This is more of an illustration approach, instead trying not to generate hair using, for example, fiber mesh. And because of it, there isn't shortcuts here, just slowly building them up one by one. The faster you will end up looking for shortcuts and time savers, the faster you will start create better hair in this approach. This took me 5.5 hours to create. When I'm happy with one side, I will duplicate it and then shift a bit to break the symmetry. It's probably the longest part and it's crucial to check the direction of clumps against the reference, or you will end up with a complete mess. Been there, done that. Okay, here we go, some clumps. In this chapter we will break the clumps using polygroups and create a regulation while constantly checking ourselves against the reference, to know how much of the breakup to do. We also will add the secondary front clumps and small braids. To break them, I hit the auto groups button, which you can find in the polygroups menu, and turn on the mask by polygroups option. This way, my move brush can take only one subclump at a time. This is exactly the same process I did for the side clumps. I created the dirty base using a sphere and drawing the clumps on it. This way I can easily create a spiral looking hair and then delete the base. And again the same process, but for small braids this time. The braid brush also have subclumps that will greatly help us to sell realism with small tweaks later on. adding small hair bands using the same process like in the hair bun in the back, and introducing small hairs for a nice soft finish. These small stuff are adding a ton of appeal. I took the old character to Transpose Master, which you can find in Z-Plugin Mania. This allows me to manipulate all the subtools together with Move Rush and correct the overall shape without ruining the correlation between individual hair clumps and the base. The last chapter this extra mile of the hair sculpting is flyaway hairs. Flyaway hair is the hair which isn't quite following the general direction of a clump. Like how much flyaways and how hard they break, the overall direction is dictated by the hairstyle you're after, type of the hair and overall conditions. For example, wet hair won't have them or have a small amount of flyaways. For them, I'm using the regular curved tube brush, adding a bunch of them and then start bending them to a place one by one. Try not to create them too thin, they can look strange if the thickness will be really small compared to the rest of the clumps. Pay and exert attention to our root placements. Roots are the most hard part for any computer-generated hair. The penetration to the sculpt is killing the realistic effect. Obviously, I'm creating here a concept illustration, but still, I'm placing the roots in the right direction with the true to this hairstyle breaks and shifts. Don't forget to pay extra attention to the roots while analyzing your references. In the end, I added a small amount of flyaways that went on top of a band to create just a little extra details in this area. Here we go, the concept is done and we can start placing cards while using this as a precise guide for it. I hope you enjoyed the video, hit the like and subscribe button because a lot more content to come. Thank you and have a great day. Constantine.